In Academy District 20, sportsmanship is year-round. I'm Superintendent Mark Hatchell, and I've seen countless examples of sportsmanship by our athletes, coaches, and fans. From help up after a tough fall to encouraging words following a difficult loss, our athletes know the true meaning of sportsmanship.
Gets it to Love, makes a fake baseline, goes to the middle, and throws in the hook shot.
Sportsmanship to me is respecting your coaches, officials, players, and the other fans. Cheer for your team, but also appreciate the other team.
Sportsmanship to me means always putting forth your best effort to help the team, respecting yourself as well as the others around you, and treating your body right.
Sportsmanship to me is respecting one another and understanding the other team's right to cheer.
Sportsmanship to me is respect. Respecting yourself, your teammates, and your opponents.
The set, left side, sent down, inbounds or out of bounds, that is inbounds for Amanda Cushion.
Sportsmanship is being enthusiastic about your accomplishments while also respecting other players and their achievements.
Throws left side to the end zone! And the catch is made! That's a touchdown!
At Academy School District 20,
sportsmanship is year-round.
And we do welcome you back into Cadet Ice Arena, generally home of the Air Force Falcons, but tonight, home of the school just down the road, still on the campus here at the United States Air Force Academy. That is the Cadets of Air Academy, and they are playing host to Cheyenne Mountain. I'm Matt Wally, Dave Toller, alongside our entire 20 TV crew. Look, we know, first game of the year, there's a little jittery at times. You don't know exactly what to expect. But when you're playing against your arch rival, how does that affect things?
I think it should be a great game. I mean, these two teams played twice last season. They know each other very well. I'm sure a lot of these guys, being in the same city, they've played on the same club teams, and they played together against each other. So they know each other very well. And I think it'll be interesting how this game plays out. As we talked in the open a little bit, you know, Air Academy, such a young team. They've got so many new guys in the lineup. Cheyenne Mountain, a little bit more of a veteran team. We'll see how that affects the first part of this game.
You know, it's kind of funny because these teams mirror some other things. We just recently had Air Force and Colorado College play. Well, here we have Air Force and Cheyenne Mountain, Air Academy and Cheyenne Mountain. Air Academy, obviously, on the campus of the Air Force Academy. You know, Cheyenne Mountain, they practice over at Hanen Ice Arena, same place that CC. So it's kind of a high school version of another really big rivalry in this town, hockey-wise.
Well, it really is. I mean, you got the North against the South. And, you know, I'm sure in terms of the rink itself, Air Academy and their players, they've been here a little bit more, so they know the bounces, they know the corners. When you talk about rinks with shallow corners or egg-shaped, and where Cheyenne Mountain probably not quite as used to this rink as the Air Academy kids are.
We just saw Cheyenne Mountain introduce their starters. Air Academy came to the blue line as a team.
Very interesting.
Yeah. I don't know. Sometimes we see that in football where instead of introducing the offense or the defense, they'll introduce the entire team. I guess maybe that's the attitude that's being taken by Air Academy. Either way, Cheyenne Mountain ends up on the stick of Scioli. Now it comes back out. Cheyenne Mountain with it. Here's a shot. Not very good contact made down there by Logan Heibel. And Cheyenne Mountain tries to control in their zone. Air Academy comes away with it. And here come the Cadets. Stick battle around center ice and offsides as we see Landon Joyle trying to come across, and seemed like the Cadets might have a head of steam there for just a moment.
Yeah, they did. They were stuck in their own zone for about the first 30 seconds. They finally got it out and started to come into the Indians' end. They jumped offside. We'll have a faceoff right down in front of us.
Austin Gasper against Justin Chiachi, going to be won by Cheyenne Mountain as Gasper brings the puck down on the left side. Comes back around the net all the way down in the corner. He brings it all the way to the top. That's Teague with it. Teague sends it down to that right corner. Cadets get it for a moment behind the goal. Now the puck comes loose out to that far, or actually that near side corner, and it's going to be picked up by Joyle, and Joyle's going to try to lead a Cadet attack. Last year, Air Academy defeated Cheyenne Mountain 4-2 and 6-2 in their two matchups during the course of the season. Cheyenne Mountain comes away with a steal, and the Indians will try to move it forward across the red line into the zone. And here's somewhat of a weak shot off the stick of 22, who's not listed on our roster. And that is the first shot of the game.
And you can see on the replay there, just coming in over the blue line, one on two. He had two defensemen right in front of him, dumps it in on net, and Stoles covers up and doesn't give up a rebound.
So the faceoff is won by Gavin Garrett Johnson, sent all the way down. And Cheyenne Mountain tries to come away with it. They do, and they'll try to push it into their offensive zone. Sean Halverson leading the attack. It is taken away by Mylon Habrill. And the Cadets move it forward once again. Here's Cooley with it over to the corner. Fans wanted a penalty. They're not going to get it. The Cadets try to keep it in their zone, and instead they put the puck into the Cheyenne Mountain bench.
Well, coming down the left wing side, that was a freshman. That was Gavin Garrett Johnson, who had the puck on his stick, and he got just inside of the top of the circles. Looked like he caught a toe, caught an edge, and just fell down on the play. I know some of the fans here wanted a penalty. We didn't see a whole lot, and looked like they were going to drop the puck on the dot over by the Cheyenne Mountain bench. Instead, they'll move it right to center ice.
That's where it is won by Cheyenne Mountain, as A.J. Wilkie had it for a moment. He pushes it ahead to Heibel. Heibel has it now to the center. Here's another shot on goal right from the middle. That's Van Havinga. Havinga is a 5'8", 185-pound junior. Couple shots on goal here in the early going for Cheyenne Mountain, but not a lot on these shots.
Well, and from way outside, too. Both teams having trouble getting anything going down low. Air Academy has had the puck in the Cheyenne Mountain and just briefly before the Indians have taken it and taken it right back in.
Faceoff controlled by the Cadets, but Cheyenne Mountain gets it back in their defensive zone and they push forward. This is Trevor Taylor on the left side. Another shot on net. I have to wonder if Eric Austin has said to his team in the early going, just start peppering the net, because they're not getting good looks at the net. They're just putting the puck on it.
And, you know, sometimes you throw stuff to the net, good things happen. Sometimes you'll get a tip. It goes off of a skate maybe, but Stoles has done a nice job of not giving up a rebound.
Face-off controlled by Air Academy as they try to get it out of their zone. That was Trent Chiga who had it. Cheyenne Mountain gets it back. Here's a long shot from the top. It was deflected, controlled down in the corner by Tyson Henson. Now, Cadets have it at least for a moment in their defensive zone. Fight for it on those far boards. Taken away by Austin Gasper for Cheyenne Mountain. Now the puck is loosed. It's grabbed by Jared Taylor, and Taylor's going to lead a 3-on-2 attack for the Cadets. If they hurry, no. Losing it was Justin Chiaccia, and Cheyenne Mountain gets it back in their defensive zone. 2-on-1 stick battle down there in the far corner. It's going to come out to mid-ice. The puck will, and it's going to be taken away by Cheyenne Mountain. Moving it forward, that was Henson. Now a centering pass comes over to Sauer. Puck back behind the net. Another centering pass. Cadet's got a stick on it, but it sticks with Cheyenne Mountain on the right side. That's A.J. Wilkie sending it down on the right side to, again, number 11, who is also not on our roster for Cheyenne Mountain. We've got a couple of them in there. Centering pass comes right to the middle. It's not going to get on the stick of an Indian, and the Cadets have it, trying to push it into their zone. This is Taylor with it. Taylor has it taken away. These two teams still kind of trying to figure each other out. Cadets trying to get some prolonged time there in their offensive zone. Puck being fought for, middle of the ice. It's taken away once again by the unnamed number 11, and he will try to push it forward up that left side. Almost taken away. Still has it, just dumps it down in the corner as Cheyenne Mountain will get a change and Air Academy will get it back. This is Kirkendall sitting at the left side. No, it's going to be taken away. The Halverson's got it on the far side. Halverson goes from right to left. Now he's going to dump it off to one of his defenders, and they'll try again. Pass comes from right to left, intended for Halverson. He's got to go down to the corner to get it. Not going to get to it before Lichtenberger. Lichtenberger sends it around. Puck on that far end. Now it comes loose back behind the net. Not many people knew it came all the way over. Centering pass taken away, stolen away by Ian Rainey, and Rainey will lead ahead. He's almost looked like a trip and a whistle, but I don't think they're going to get the penalty instead. I think that was an offsides call.
Nope, I think they got it, Matt. They're going to get. Rainey was coming up the near side boards, and just as he was about to get out of the zone, he was tripped up on the play. Cadets will go on the power play. The tripping penalty called on Cheyenne Mountain. Sean Halverson. Halverson goes into the penalty box. First penalty of this game, and the Cadets are on the power play, and they get a faceoff in the offensive zone.
5'9 senior Halverson goes off, and now Aaron Ortiz with a very important faceoff for Air Academy as they try to get their first prolonged offensive attack. It is won by the Cadets, and they'll try to set up the power play. First power play for either team, controlled by Joyle. Joyle's got it on the near boards, trying to get that puck loose. Ortiz got it for a second. Now it goes down to the corner and Rainey. Rainey was the one who was just tripped. The puck comes up to the top, over to Joyle. Joyle's going to put a shot on goal. Actually, check that. It's just a shot. It's going to go above the goal and into the netting, and that's going to allow Cheyenne Mountain to change. It looks like Air Academy is going to leave their power play unit out there.
What a nice job by Air Academy moving that puck down. You saw it go from the right side to the left, up to the point, all the way across. Took Joyle a little bit of time to get that shot off. It was tipped before it got in on goal, went out of play. 1:37 left to the Cadet power play.
Took the officials a moment to go find a puck, and they finally got one. The faceoff is won by Cheyenne Mountain. Big hit here on the near side. Joyle was able to put down Wilkie for Cheyenne Mountain. First big hit of the game as the Cadets control in their zone on the power play. A minute 22 to go in the man advantage. Cheyenne Mountain controls for a moment. They send it around. It'll come all the way out to Scioli for the Cadets, and he dumps it back behind the net. Cheyenne Mountain gets it, sends it up to the blue line. Cadets can't control, and now Cheyenne Mountain with it, moving it forward. This is Wilkie, and Wilkie just dumps it back behind the net, and Cheyenne Mountain will get a couple new players onto the ice. Cadets taking some time to work it back into their offensive zone. They're on the man advantage for another 49 seconds. Puck comes back around. Air Academy tries to control. This is Ortiz behind the net. Here's a centering pass. Good idea. Better play defensively by Cheyenne Mountain. Another big hit as Rainey was able to take down one of the Indians. Another big hit on the near side. Cadets are the more aggressive team right now in terms of hits. Here's a shot from the right side by Taylor, and the save is made. Save made by Jason Stoles, the goalie. Now back in the other direction. There's a shot. Save made by Ryan McCann. Cadets have 11 seconds left on this man advantage. Hit right in the middle of the ice, and Cheyenne Mountain gets the puck, sends it back down towards their offensive zone. Cadets have it, but Cheyenne Mountain does a nice job of killing off the penalty.
Yeah, sure did. They only gave up one shot on goal. Air Academy just got the one from the point that was saved by McCann. That's the Cadets' only shot of this game so far.
Cameron Sauer dumps it in, picked up in there down there in the corner, and Air Academy will try to move it forward right now. Possession goes to that number 11. Now A.J. Wilkie comes over for Cheyenne Mountain. He's got it back behind the net. He's going to dump it back over the right side as Andy Teague, the 6-foot junior, sends it back up. And here come the Indians with it. Left off on the near side, comes out to the middle. This is Army Pfeffer, first time we've called his name today. Pfeffer can't control. Takes down a Cadet, no call. Looked like a pretty clean hit from up here. And Cheyenne Mountain trying to get something going in their offensive zone. Air Academy has controlled the puck, but they haven't been able to get it out of their defensive zone. 9 minutes, 49 seconds to go in the first period. Here's a shot, and it went high. That was off the stick of A.J. Wilkie. Now it comes back out to the right side. This is Teague. Teague sends it to the middle. Here's a shot, good deflection, as I believe that was Lichtenberger for the Cadets who may have gotten in the way of it. Cheyenne Mountain has it down in the corner, bringing it back around. Puck's loose, near corner, fight for it. Going to be controlled for a moment by Cheyenne Mountain, and now the puck comes back around the net. People took a moment to try to find where that was, and it's grabbed down there in the far corner by Cheyenne Mountain. Now they're going to fight for it. Puck's loose for a moment. Cadets had the chance for it, didn't realize it was there. You can kind of tell it's the first game of the season. Puck comes up to the top. This is Sauer and a shot, but he's going to be offsides first.
Yeah, he was well offside on that play, and he catches it right at the blue line, pulls it back, and brought it over the line. You could see the pad save there by Jason Stoles. We'll get another look at it right here. That's the best save of the game so far as he sticks that right pad out there, makes the save. No score in this one. 9:04 left in the first period in the faceoff out to the neutral zone.
And it's going to be controlled by Cheyenne Mountain as Ryan Smith had it for a moment, sends it out to the right side. That's Teague. Teague had it for a moment. Now a tripping call will go against the Cadets as Max Schultz went down and went down hard.
Yeah, it's going to be an elbowing penalty. They're going to get Ian Rainey and a big hit. And we talked about earlier, it was on Air Academy's own power play. They were very physical. They had about three or four big hits down in their own offensive zone. That time it was in Cheyenne Mountain's end, and Rainey came up and would have been in good shape, but he got the arm up. You can see it right there coming through. If he keeps the arms down and goes to the chest, he's okay, but penalty on Rainey. Power play for the Indians.
The Cadets do not score on their power play. We'll see what Cheyenne Mountain can do with it. This is Smith. Smith gets it back behind the net. Now it comes out to the corner as they try to set things up. Big hit. Puck comes loose. Cadets had it for just a moment, and now it comes back behind the net. Foot race to get to it, and Trevor Taylor is there first for Cheyenne Mountain. Taylor, good idea on the centering pass, but it just goes out of the reach of Cameron Sauer. Puck on the near side, comes back around. It's picked up by Hovinga. Hovinga's got it on that far slot. Centering pass, really good centering pass. A shot and a goal as Cheyenne Mounted comes away. Cameron Sauer, the first goal of his career. He's a freshman, and Cheyenne Mounted takes the 1-0 lead on a power play goal.
Boy, what a great feed by Van Hovinga. Look at this pass from right here. Threads it through the skates, the stick blades, everything. Puts it right on the tape of Cameron Sauer. The first goal of this game, first goal of the season, puts Cheyenne Mountain up 1-0, 8:17 left first period.
I think that went five hole on Jason Stoles, the sophomore goalkeeper. Cheyenne Mountain has a 1-0 lead. They get the power play goal, and now let's see if the Cadets can come up with a response. The faceoff was won by Cheyenne Mountain as they pushed it in their zone, but Air Academy comes up with it. It'll be dumped down ahead for Chiaccia. He gets to it, and he'll just veer off with it. Tried to center it over to Taylor. Taylor never got it. Instead, Cheyenne Mountain does. They've got it down in that far corner, and they'll try to push it forward. Cadets continue to be very physical out there, and it produces a turnover. Air Academy will backskate in their defensive zone. They lose the puck. Cheyenne Mountain's got it once again, moving forward. This is Halverson. Halverson dumps it down to the corner, trying to get it over to Austin Gasper. Four players are down there trying to get possession of the puck, and it comes up to Vince Primavera. Here's a attempted shot. Stoles was there. I'm not sure if that puck got all the way to him. Either way, no goal in Cheyenne Mountain. And Air Academy gets changed for that matter. Now a Cadet falls down, bad turnover as Army Pfeffer has it, but Cheyenne Mountain will just skate off, and the Cadets will get it once again, trying to push in their offensive zone up that right side, taken away again. This is Pfeffer. Pfeffer's got some room. He gets around one defender. Good move, puts the shot on goal, and Stoles is there to make the glove save. It wouldn't have been a goal. It was off to the left, but still a nice job by Stoles to be right there.
Boy, great hands there by Pfeffer, though. As you could see him go forehand, backhand, dances through a couple of Cadets, gets in and gets the shot. And credit Jason Stoles. He's been busy. Gets the glove on that one, holds on, and it'll be a faceoff in the offensive end for the Indians.
Pfeffer, a 6-3 forward, 6 minutes and 52 seconds to go. Here's a quick shot from the right side, and it goes to the wide right of the goal, 6 minutes and 44 seconds to go here in this first period. A Cadet is taken down. That was Rainey. Does not look like there's going to be a call as the puck comes back into the Cheyenne Mountain zone, but the Cadets have control of it. Trying to get out of there with it. It's Forrest Joyle. Joyle sends it out to the left side, and Habrel. Habrel had it for a moment. Puck's loose. Brian Suslow for Cheyenne Mountain gets the steal. Big hit on the far side. And that got the Cadet student section going just a bit here at Cadet Ice Arena. Here's Habrel sending it down. Goes off a Cheyenne Mountain player. Bounces back out toward center ice and then comes back all the way around. The goalkeeper, McCann, will play for just a moment, and Cheyenne Mountain will try to push into their offensive zone. Here's Smith with it. Smith trying to get around Scioli for Air Academy, having a hard time with it. It's going to come back over to Sauer. Sauer scoring the first goal of his career before. He sends it forward to Gasper. Gasper's got it on the left side. Skates back behind the goal, down to the corner, looking to pass. Still has it. Now here's a centering pass. It's taken away by Joyle, and the Cadets will try to push forward. Ahead to Ortiz. Ortiz had it for a moment. Now the puck's loose, comes down into the corner. Grabbing hold of it is Sauer for Cheyenne Mountain. Could not get out behind the net, though. Fight for the puck. Stick battle won by the Cadets as they'll try to set up their offense. Here's a shot from the top. It goes off the goalkeeper, McCann. Not sure if he completely saw that. Deflection comes back out to Wilkie, and Wilkie's got it behind the net, and he'll try to push forward. Just over 5 minutes to go in the period. bad pass somehow ends up on the stick of Wilkie. Wilkie's got it on the right side out of the circle, and now a buzzer went off. That might have been coming from the basketball arena back behind us. 4 minutes and 50 seconds to go, and now Air Academy trying to get a bit of an attack. Forgetting the puck, though, was Anthony Scioli, and here comes Cheyenne Mountain back in the other direction. Cadets come up with the steal, and they'll go back in the other direction. Back and forth we go. That was Taylor, who had it for a moment, ends up on the stick of Primavera. Primavera had it for a moment. Now Cheyenne Mountain gets it, trying to push ahead. It's Pfeffer. Pfeffer had it. Over to Smith, and now the puck comes all the way back towards the goaltender Stoles, and these two teams may slow things down just a bit.
Well, they are. A good back-and-forth play through the neutral zone. You can see both teams trying to get a little bit of a trap set up and create a turnover, but both struggling to get anything going in the offensive end.
Chiachi had taken down in the far corner after he had that puck, tried to center it, but nobody was there. Now it comes to the top. Here's a big shot from Lichtenberger, and that bounced in, and the goalkeeper McCann was able to make the save. 4 minutes to go in the period. It's 1-0. Cheyenne Mountain leads. Cadets with the puck. And puck's loose right in front of the goalkeeper. That's the last place he wanted. Stoles was just kind of standing there. Puck ahead. It's going to cross center ice and come all the way by the Cheyenne Mountain bench, grabbing his Chiachia for the Cadets. Now taken away by Cheyenne Mountain, but it comes right to the top. Let's see if they get a shot off, and it's going to go wide to the left from the shot right from the point. Grabbing it down there is Taylor. Taylor sends it back up top. This is Joyle. Joyle gives off left side. Shot goes through, is deflected, but it's going to go over the net as McCann didn't have to grab hold of it. Puck down in the corner. 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go. First period, Cheyenne Mountain leads 1-0. Cheyenne Mountain with it, trying to push it forward, not able to do so. Comes back to Halverson. Halverson has it, gives off. Indians have it, but they can't cross center ice. Now they do. Moving forward, the pass comes out to the right side. That's Trevor Taylor with it. Taylor couldn't quite control. Comes back out to Matt DiPepe near center ice. Now back to left side. This is Taylor with it, working against two Cadets. Down in the corner, Taylor still has it. Big check down there. Taylor controls. Now he gives off. Cheyenne Mountain with it. Have some space. Here's a shot from the top from A.J. Wilkie, and that goes over the net. But the Indians do continue to control. Gasper with it has it. A couple Cadets right next to him, and Air Academy comes up with the steal. They'll try to push it forward. Here's Rainey. Cross center ice, dumps it down in the left corner. Cadets will get a quick change. Just one Air Academy player down there by the puck, and she's able to get it as it comes up all the way to the near side. Puck being fought for. Three Cheyenne Mountain players, one Cadet, and as you would expect, Cheyenne Mountain is able to win that possession. 2 minutes and 16 seconds to go. First period, 1-0 is our score. And now a whistle on a check, and we'll see what the call is. Seemed like that whistle almost came before that check.
It did, Matt. They're going to call offside on the play over on the far side. The Indians got in just a little too quick. Cheyenne Mountain, 7 shots on goal in this game. Air Academy with 3, and the Indians lead. This one, the only goal of this game came from Cameron Sauer.
2 minutes and 8 seconds to go here in this first period. It is 1-0. Cheyenne Mountain leads. They lost both matchups to Air Academy last year, but Air Academy losing about 80% of their production from last year's team. Here's Cheyenne Mountain with it, trying to push it forward as quick as they can, right in the middle of the ice. This is Sauer, who had the goal earlier. Sauer can't quite control. He gets it back behind. Now a centering pass. Puck is loose, and the goalkeeper, Stoles, fell down, but he didn't fall down on it. Cheyenne Mountain still continues to control. Big hit right in front of the net. As for Air Academy, that was Lichtenberger, who was trying to clear out the area in front of the net. Pass right side. Rebound given up. Pass comes back. Puck comes back out. And Cadets are lucky right there that shot didn't end up going in.
Exactly, Matt. And they went ahead and iced the puck right there. But you can see here on the replays, there's the first shot. There's a rebound chance. Stoles, again, doing a great job. Couldn't quite cover it up, but the Cadets had to do anything they could to get that puck out of the zone. Boy, two good chances. How about the left flipper just kicking out there at the last second by Stoles, doing a great job in this first period. Faceoff down to the left of Stoles.
Controlled by the Cadets, and they'll try to push it forward just out of the reach of Primavera. And it's going to come all the way back to Wilkie. Wilkie gives it off. Cheyenne Mountain with about 70 seconds to go here in this first period. We'll try to get one more offensive tack. The puck comes all the way down, controlled for a moment by Chiga. Chiga sends it over to Joyle. Joyle tries to get it down there in the corner. It comes up to Chiachia, and here comes the Cadets with it. They have a 3-on-2. Instead, they'll just dump it back behind, and they'll get a bit of a change in. Cheyenne Mountain gains control. 49 seconds to go in the first period. It goes off the stick of Van Hovinga, and the Cadets have it. We'll see what they can do with 40 seconds left. Try to get one more offensive tack turnover. This is Taylor. Taylor on the right side gets around one defender. Now it ended up with Gasper. That shot didn't get all the way through, and the Cadets have it. Dumping out to the right side. This is Joyle. Joyle's got it in the corner. Here's a shot to that near side, and nice job by the goalkeeper, McCann, to be in good position.
Boy, best scoring chance of the period for the Cadets right there. Nice job by Joyle as he's coming through the neutral zone. It was a two-on-two. He chips it off the boards. He wins the race to get down and tries to go short side and nearly got the Cadets on the board.
Do you like the short side attack?
I like it right there. Yeah, he didn't have much of a choice. He got in a little too deep.
Off the faceoff, puck came loose out in front of the net, and McCann was ready for it. Cheyenne Mountain has it, 12 seconds to go here in this first period. It is 1-0 Cheyenne Mountain on a Cameron Sauer goal. Indians have it, 6 seconds to go. They'll have to get one more shot off. They do, the puck right in front of the net, a shot and a goal with 1.1 seconds to go here in this first period. It's 2-0 Cheyenne Mountain. We'll check the replay. And it's that number 11 who unfortunately is not on our roster, so we can't properly attribute who that is who scored the goal.
Well, he played a whale of a period too, and you can see the first one is a tip in. What a great angle here. Goes through the legs of the goaltender off the post, and then we'll just call him number 11, follows up his own shot and puts it in for a 2-0 Indians lead. And you heard the horn go off. That's the end of the first period.
2-0 the score. Cheyenne Mountain leads Air Academy. We'll take a break. We'll have more. Second period right around the corner right here on 20 TV.
One part excellence. One part inspiration. One part preparation for outstanding education. Academy School District 20, where dreams take flight.
First intermission, Cheyenne Mountain leads Air Academy 2-0. Matt Pauly, Dave Toller back at the Cadet Ice Arena at the United States Air Force Academy. Let's take a look at the highlights from the first period as Cheyenne Mountain scores both goals. And there we see the first goal coming from Cameron Sauer, the freshman, his first career goal. And he was able to go five-hole on the goalie, Jason Stolls. And then with just about 1 second left, the tip-in by Sean Herlihy. We found out just a few moments ago, number 11, not on anybody's roster. Dave, I said a few moments ago, he literally is the secret weapon because he played a pretty good first period. Sean Herlihy scoring his first goal of the year.
Oh, he did. He played a great first period, had several chances, and then the goal he scored, 1.1 seconds left. And, you know, as you tell every young player, follow your shot, stay with it. He did so. His first shot went off the post. It came right back to him. Herlihy comes in, puts it in, and the Indians are up 2-0.
2-0. First intermission. We'll come back with second period action next here on 20 TV. We are back at the Cadet Ice Arena. Second period action coming your way. Matt Pauly, Dave Toller, thanks so much for being with us tonight here on 20 TV. We'll see if Air Academy can answer here in the second period. Generally, second period, a little more advantageous for goals being scored.
Well, and we'll see if it is. And Cheyenne Mountain wins that opening faceoff, throws it in right away. But I thought early on in that first period, Air Academy was very, very physical. Part of being physical, they took a penalty, led to a power play goal by Cheyenne Mountain in the first period.
Cadets had it for a moment. It's taken back away by Cheyenne Mountain as they're in their offensive zone. They're going from left to right from our vantage point here in this second period. Right in front of the net, there's a shot. It goes off the back of one of the players, and the Cadets come up with it. They'll try to push it forward. No, another steal. Cheyenne Mountain has come out with all kinds of energy. Puck's loose to the left of the goalkeeper, Stolls. Puck's still loose over there. And now it's going to come back to the top. Here's a long shot. Doesn't make it all the way to the net. deflects back down into the corner. That's Smith with it for Cheyenne Mountain, who sends it around the boards, and it's going to be grabbed by Cameron Sauer. Sauer gives off. Hovinga had it for just a moment. Now a stick battle for it. Nice job to get a check in there by the Cadets, and they got the possession for a moment. Eventually he comes back around to Scioli, and Scioli will try to push it forward. No, Cheyenne Mountain comes up with another steal. Cadets are having a hard time just getting it out of their defensive zone. There was Herlihy with it for just a moment. A man we did not know was number 11 in that first period. Played well. 2-0 is our score as Cheyenne Mountain is leading Air Academy. Puck comes back to center ice. Wilkie had it. Now there's a shot, goes wide left to the right of Stoles. Now there's another one-time opportunity from the left side. Solid stick contact wasn't made. Puck sent to around center ice, but the Cadets still just cannot clear it out of the zone and get into their offensive zone. Here comes Cheyenne Mountain again. They were able to get a change in and still keep it pretty much on their side of center ice. Puck down towards that far corner. Number of players fighting for. It's finally grabbed by Scioli for the Cadets, but it comes back near the top. That's Wilkie who had it. Wilkie dumps it back in down towards the corner. Halverson tries to get it for Cheyenne Mountain. Puck comes right to the top. Dump back towards the blue line. Here's a shot. Doesn't make it all the way through, but Gasper is there to try to put it back in. He couldn't get his shot to go either. He took it to the corner, takes a check, but still contains or controls possession of the puck. Cheyenne Mountain very impressive here in the early going of the second period as they've spent the entire time, close to 3 minutes now, in there on their side of the ice. Puck comes out towards the blue line. Puck's loose, and the Cadets try to clear, and they do. And as funny as it might sound, just clearing it is something accomplished for Air Academy.
Well, just having so much trouble getting out of their own end. Cheyenne Mountain with that much end zone time, but they haven't gotten any shots in on the goalie. Air Academy has blocked a number of shots before they've gotten in on Jason Stoles.
That's Rainey who has it for Air Academy. He pushes it ahead on the right side towards Garrett Johnson. Johnson lost it. Puck's loose. Got guys just sliding all over the place right now. There's a shot that goes wide right. Good idea by Rainey out there, but couldn't get it. Physical contact, shot, and a goal from the left side. That was Cooley who put it in. It went off the back of the goaltender McCann, and Air Academy gets their first goal of the night.
Boy, what a great dish, too, from the far side, and you can see Cooley here on the near side, right there on the back door, wide open, good pass. First one wouldn't go. It bounces off of the goaltender and goes in. And how many times do you see one team with so much end zone time and they couldn't put it away? That was Cheyenne Mountain. What a good look right there. The goalie turned around. That was Ryan McCann trying to sweep it out of the way, and he ends up knocking it in the net. But the Cadets finally get on the board. Cheyenne Mountain, a ton of end zone time to start with. Cadets get one opportunity. They get somebody wide open on the back door, and they put it away.
And sometimes better to be lucky than good, because Cooley, wide open net, put it on the post. And then she got lucky because it goes off the goaltender McCann.
Yeah, and that's what, you know, good things happen when you throw things to the net. And that one hit the post. It didn't go in the first time, but gets knocked in by the goalie. And something good happening to Air Academy early in the second period.
Katie Cooley, sophomore forward, gets the goal. The first goal of the year for each of these teams comes from a freshman. 2-1 our score. Cheyenne Mountain still leads, but the Cadets have a little momentum, and they'll try to score that second goal if they possibly can sooner than later. There's a check on the near side. May have dropped that shoulder, and I think there's going to be a penalty coming against the Cadets.
Yep, going to be an interference call, and right up here against the near side boards, and they're going to send in Forrest Joyle. Joyle, such a physical player in this game. We've seen it in the offensive zone, in the defensive zone. There's one right there. Was okay for a while, but once you hit that guy, you got to let him go. Joyle gets called for interference. Second penalty of the game called on Air Academy. Second power play for Cheyenne Mountain. Their first power play they scored on back in the first period.
Probably not something you would see that play exactly called in college or pro, but here at the high school level, just long enough stayed in contact to be able to get that call made. Puck sent down the ice. It is controlled for a moment by McCann for Cheyenne Mountain. Cheyenne Mountain 1-for-1 on the power play today. They're having a hard time just getting into their zone. About 30 seconds off the clock in this power play, and Cheyenne Mountain finally gets things going. Here's Smith with it. Smith comes back around the goal looking for a centering pass. Doesn't have it. We'll send it all the way to the top. Now here's a big shot. Didn't make it all the way through. Backhand shot. I'm not sure if Stoles saw it, but Stoles made the save. And here come the Cadets with it. Air Academy maybe looking for the shorthanded goal. Here's a shot from the right side. Comes out of the hands of Ian Rainey. And it gets deflected down the corner. Might have another penalty coming. This, lots of physical activity. Some punches being thrown right in front of the goal. There you see the officials trying to clear the masses. And that's not something you want to see in high school hockey.
Well, it really isn't. And, you know, this game has been getting more and more physical the longer that it's gone on. But that's something you never want to see out there. And the referees get in. They get everything broken up. They split up the two teams. And now we'll just wait to see what penalties they call out of that.
There was a penalty being called before the scrum. So I would think we'll see three penalties here total. We'll wait and see. Have Ian Rainey? No. So going into the goal is Ortiz. No, check that. Cameron Sauer goes in for Cheyenne Mountain. And for Air Academy, Ian Rainey is listed on the board, but he has yet to go into the penalty box.
Yeah, he started into the box. He was the first guy that went into the penalty box, and then he came out. But, yeah, his number is up on the board. Sauer, who scored the first goal of this game, he was involved in that little fracas down there. So he ends up going in the box, and we'll see who they put in for Air Academy. They did have Rainey up on the board.
Now it might end up being Ortiz. Maybe not. We're just watching. And as much as people who watch professional hockey enjoy the fighting, that's part of professional hockey. It's not part of high school hockey. And as much as these two teams might be rivals, that's something that quite honestly does not have a place in the high school game.
Well, it really doesn't. And you know, as these players advance in their hockey careers, and if they go on to play juniors and play at the collegiate level, juniors is different from the collegiate level, but it is highly discouraged in college. Rarely do you see a college hockey fight.
So Rainey just went in for Air Academy. So right now there's two players in for the Cadets, one of which was the previous penalty from a little while ago. That was Joel. I'd have to think there'd be one more penalty called here, but maybe not. Have Anthony Scioli, a junior defenseman, and Van Hovinga, a junior forward, serving as the two captains. Great learning opportunity for these two individuals as well as captains to be able to sit there and be talked to by the officials with a certain level of respect that goes along with it.
Well, absolutely. And you're representing your team in that situation. And your job as that captain, as that official, that head referee is talking to you, is to relay that message back to your coaches and back to your teammates on both sides and both of these young men getting talked to by that head referee.
12:01 to go. 2-1 is our score. Cheyenne Mountain leads. Matt Pauley, Dave Toller, our entire 20 TV crew. Great opportunity for these two teams as well. They get to play on 20 TV, and with that, they play here at Cadet Ice Arena. Good student sections from both teams, but you still got to remember, you might be playing on a more vaulted piece of ice, but you're still playing high school hockey.
You are, and you know, that's one thing we hadn't talked about, Matt. Well, what a great crowd we have here tonight. I mean, this near side, there's a lot of people. You might not be able to see it if you're watching at home on the stream. Our cameras are on this same side, but boy, nice crowd, nice student section from both. And you know, during the intermission, they got a big rouse of applause when the Zamboni came out. Both sides, so both of these teams with good support from their students and their fans.
With all due respects to Sertich Ice Arena, this is not Sertich Ice Arena.
No, it is not.
So the conversation is continuing right now. Nice job by these officials to make sure that everyone's calm from here on out. You can't have a repeat of what just happened a moment ago.
Well, and sometimes just a little break in the action. I mean, just get everything settled down. Now they've taken the penalty off the board for Sauer. Mm-hmm. Sauer is still in the box, so we will see what they called. Sauer is in the box, but they've taken him off of the board. They put another Air Academy player in the box, so we still have 56 seconds left to that penalty that was called on Joel. Then they have 2 minutes up for Rainey, and there's another Cadet in the box. So They may have called coincidental minors, coincidental roughs on that last play, and they just didn't put those up. So if this all holds up, we'll see how many players come out. It could be a 5-on-3.
That's what it's
opportunity. Yeah, we have 5 Indians on the ice. We have 3 Cadets, and the Indians will get the offensive zone faceoff. So a 5-on-3 for Cheyenne Mountain for 56 seconds.
With all due respect to the officials, they saw something that we didn't. So 5-on-3 for Cheyenne Mountain. Shot deflected away. 5-on-3 for close to a minute. That is an eternity. Cheyenne Mountain with it. Comes up to the top. Pass left side. There's the shot. It goes to the inside portion of the goal. Stoles doesn't have to make the save. They'll try that left side again with Wilkie. Now Wilkie sends it back behind with Hovinga. Hovinga has it. 29 seconds left on the 5-on-3. Comes out. Back to the top. This is Smith. Smith passes over the right side and Taylor. Taylor's shot, trying to get a deflection from Hovinga. Didn't get it. Deflection comes all the way back over. Now the puck comes loose. It just rolls in front of the goalkeeper, Stoles. 12 seconds to go on the 5-on-3. Puck at the top. Here's a shot. Doesn't get through. All the way back to the corner. Wilkie has it for a moment. 3 seconds left on the 5-on-3. 5-on-3 is over. Now it'll be 5-on-4 for a minute and 5 seconds. Cheyenne Mountain loses possession. Cadets have it moving forward. This is Ortiz on the left side. Ortiz will bring it back around the net. Tried to control, couldn't do it. 45 seconds to go here on this power play for Cheyenne Mountain. Cadets have it in their zone trying to get something going. Best way to kill a penalty is keep the puck on the other side of the ice. Now here comes Cheyenne Mountain with it. Ahead to Suslow. Suslow puts a shot on goal. Good save made by Stoles. And most importantly, he doesn't give up the rebound.
Well, you know, one thing Air Academy has done a good job of, both 5-on-5 and in their penalty kill, is they blocked a ton of shots. They've kept a lot of rubber away from their goaltender, Jason Stoles. You saw him make one right here in the 5-on-4 play. He makes the chest save and covers up. But the Cadets have done a nice job of fronting those guys at the point and blocking a lot of shots before they even get inside.
2-1 is our score as Cheyenne Mountain continues to lead Air Academy here on 20 TV. The faceoff will be controlled by Cheyenne Mountain and Sean Herlihy. Herlihy gets it up. This is Teague. Teague with it. Slot right side. Puts a shot on goal. It almost goes in. What a save by Stoles just to keep that thing out of the net. That was so close. Can't wait to see the replay and see how close that was to going in. It was very, very, very close. Puck dumped in down there into the far corner. Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Power play is over, and the Cadets get their fifth skater back on the ice. What a penalty kill by Air Academy. That was impressive. 9 minutes and 50 seconds to go. A little poke check by Taylor. Taylor trying to have possession of it. Puck comes loose. It comes all the way back to Chiga, and Chiga sends it into the offensive zone, but there defensively for Cheyenne Mountain is Teague. Teague sends it forward. Loses it, grabbing it is Rainey. Rainey has it behind. Now a back pass intended over there for Kirkendall. Couldn't handle it, but Cadets still control on their defensive side. Now it comes up to the top. This is Teague for Cheyenne Mountain. Teague had it for a moment. Puck's loose on the near side. Joyle's got it. Big hit. Still fighting for it. A bunch of checking going on here on this near side right in front of us. And the puck comes back down, and there is a whistle. 2-1 score, 9:10 to go.
And they'll empty out the penalty boxes. Those coincidental minors for roughing, they had Chiga in the penalty box for Air Academy. And let's take a look at that last shot that came in. It went in underneath Stoles. Let's see, he gets a good piece of this shot, trickles in, goes up against the post. The rebound hits the post. Boy, the iron very kind to the Cadets on that play.
It's been kind overall. One
yes,
side the goal goes in, the other side the goal doesn't. 9 minutes and 3 seconds to go. Cheyenne Mountain, here's a puck right to the goal, and there is Stoles to make the stop. A little talking going on after that whistle. Talking's okay.
Yeah, that's okay. You know, exchanging some pleasantries down there, you know, talking about Thanksgiving break most likely. You know,
it's still Air Academy Cheyenne Mountain. We're not going to be, passing roses around and singing Kumbaya. That's all right. 2-1 the score. Cheyenne Mountain leads, and they've got the puck. Here's a big shot from the top, deflected away. I think that was Rainey who got the block, and now Rainey goes down and gets it. He's bumped off the puck, centering pass, great opportunity. But for Air Academy, Garrett Johnson just could not get his stick solidly on that puck as Cheyenne Mountain sends it down. Cadets will change out one player. and they'll try to push it forward. Back into their defensive zone. Stoles gets it. Stoles sends it back to the right side. Sometimes the Cadets have more issues getting it out of the zone for Cheyenne Mountain than anything else. Here's a deflection right in front. It goes wide right. That was off the stick of Hovinga. Puck back to the top. Another deflection right in front. Point blank. Stoles lands on top of it and makes a good save. Stoles, I think, has upped his game here in the second period.
Well, he's been terrific this whole game. And as you can see here on the replay, there's the first save. There's the second. Another rebound chance. He holds his ground in there, goes down, and covers up. Jason Stoles, the left pad, makes the save, covers up in traffic. He's been terrific and keeps this a 2-1 game with almost 8 minutes left in the second period.
The way he uses his legs and the blocker pads, he does not look like a high schooler. There's a lot of smoothness to his game, which is impressive. 2-1 our score, and Stoles is only a sophomore. Puck comes ahead. Cadets try to get into the zone. They'll send it down and fight for it there. The goaltender McCann just puts his stick on it for a moment. Cadets still have it. That's Ortiz with it. Ortiz can't control. A couple players hit the deck, and Air Academy has it. They'll skate back into their defensive zone as Joyle falls as well. All of a sudden, a bunch of guys are falling. Pass comes right side. Big shot off the stick of Suslow, the save made. The Cadets try to push it forward. Chiaccia moves it forward. Has a head of steam on the right side. Shot! And it goes wide of the net. 2-1 the score. 7:15 to go. Period number two. Cheyenne Mountain quickly gain their zone, and they're offside.
Well, the Indians coming into the zone and carrying the puck in. That was Van Hovinga, gets in a little bit too quick. Yet another save there by Jason Stoles. That came in on it was a 2-on-2 over on the right wing pass, and a nice save by Stoles. That was an offside call there on the Indians. 7:11 left, second period, 2-1 Cheyenne Mountain.
And the faceoff won by Cheyenne Mountain going to the net. There's going to be a penalty. As for the Indians, Herlihy was taken to the ground.
Well, Herlihy just walked right out of that neutral zone faceoff, takes it down the right wing side, and Air Academy got in, tripped him up, and the penalty is going to go against Trent Chica. Chica goes into the box. 2 minutes for tripping. Nice play there by Herlihy. Scored a goal in the first period. Draws a penalty that puts the Indians on the power play. Their fourth power play of this game.
They've been very active on the power play. They have one power play goal, although their last power play, they had a 5-on-3 for almost a minute. And
that's going to be a high stick violation. And boy, the linesman threw that puck down awful quick. Air Academy wasn't even ready. They didn't have their fifth guy on. It ended up benefiting the Cadets because coming out of that faceoff when they went to clear it, the high stick violation on the Indians. And as a result, the faceoff comes all the way back down into the Cheyenne Mountain end.
6:53, another quick puck drop and a quick shot. And that's a save made. Scioli on the shot for Air Academy.
And a shorthanded shot. They got that faceoff down in their offensive zone. Air Academy just their third shot on goal this period, 6:48 left in the second.
Cheyenne Mountain will put some new power play skaters on the ice. 6:48 to go. Second period, it's 2-1 Cheyenne Mountain. Air Academy scored the only goal, 2-on-1 for Cheyenne Mountain. Here's a shot, rebound given up, puck's loose, and it comes back behind the net. Stoles made the initial save, and then his teammates really helped him out after that. That was Suslow with the initial shot for Cheyenne Mountain. Puck dumped back behind the net. Cadets have it for a moment. Let's see if they can clear it, and they can. And they will get some new skaters on the ice. Again here, going this direction on a power play, so tough when you're trying to kill off that power play because of where you have to skate to get to your bench when you dump off the puck. But the Cadets able to do it. Minute four to go here in this power play. 6 minutes left in the game, and the Cadets will dump it off again. Good PK right now for the Cadets.
And great kills by their defenseman. Anthony Scioli with two great kills, that last one by Forrest Joyle. And you want guys to get it 200 feet. Make them go all the way and retreat and bring it back.
2-1 score. Here's a shot from the right side. Not a lot on that. Off the stick of Trevor Taylor. I've liked Taylor's game. It seems like he's in the right place at the right time a lot.
Well, it really is. Yeah, I mean, he's had some chances, but boy, the story of this second period has been Jason Stoles, 14 saves already in this period.
That is a ton of saves, and Stoles has been good, just a sophomore. Looks good between the pipes. 2-1 the score, 5 minutes, 42 seconds, and just had Austin Gasper thrown out of the circle. It'll be Matt White to come in instead. Cadets have it. A little two-on-two break, and Cheyenne Mountain's able to play it well defensively. Habrill down in the corner, left side, loses it. Cheyenne Mountain gets it, trying to push it forward. Here's Wilkie. Wilkie sends it ahead up on the left side. This is Gasper. Gasper's in the circle. Gasper trying to control, pushed out towards the blue line. Cadets have it for a moment, comes back out to Smith. Smith passes over to Wilkie. Wilkie can't quite handle it, has to go back to the red line to control. Now his pass to that far side is just out of the reach of his teammate, and the Cadets will dump it in to try to get a change. Less than 5 minutes to go here in period number two. Cheyenne Mountain has a 2-1 lead, and here come the Indians moving it forward from left to right, moving quickly. Here is Herlihy. Herlihy has scored a goal. Herlihy loses it. Cadets have it in their defensive zone, and they will do their best to push forward. Across the red line, puck deflects all the way over towards that Air Academy bench. Jared Taylor gets it for the Cadets. Taylor can't control it as he sends it in. Cheyenne Mountain has it, and they'll just send it all the way down the ice. That's going to be an icing, and we will see the puck brought all the way back down. Not many. I think that's only the second icing in this game.
Yeah, there hasn't been a whole lot of them, and that time Cheyenne Mountain was trying to hit number six, Micah McInnes, who was right at the red line looking for a little tip to get it in the zone and a little dump and chase hockey and just didn't get that tip. So Air Academy will get a faceoff in the offensive zone.
2-1 game, 4 minutes and 23 seconds to go. Here in period number two, Cheyenne Mountain lead. Cheyenne Mountain with the puck. Right to the middle, there's a big shot by Taylor, but he didn't make solid contact with it. But the Cadets keep the puck in their zone, pass to the middle intended for Taylor, taken away by Smith, and Smith will hold for a moment behind the net. He pushes it up to Sauer. Sauer has scored a goal today. Long pass, almost stolen away. Sean Halverson's able to go back and get it. Cheyenne Mountain controlled for a moment. Cadets have it back 3-2 if they hurry. From the right side, here's a centering pass, not a whole lot on it. It was Rainey who had it for a moment. Now he gets it back right behind the net. Check that. That's actually Lichtenberger, and Lichtenberger's shot doesn't go, and the goalkeeper, McCann, will just sit there and make sure the puck doesn't get in.
Oh, and it started out as a 3-on-2 for Air Academy, and then they went off for a line change, so then they got the puck in, they dumped it down deep, and the puck got tied up over on the net. That's why it took a while for that whistle to blow. Grant Lichtenberger was in trying to dig it out and poke it free. McCann reached around and covered it up. 3:41 left, second period.
3 minutes and 41 seconds, as you say. Thanks, Dave. 2-1 is our score. Cheyenne Mountain leads. Sometimes it helps to listen to the person you're working with. Broadcasting 101. Here's the pass near the top. That's Kirkendall with it. Kirkendall has the puck stolen away, and Suslow brings it up for Cheyenne Mountain. Suslow takes a big hit on the near side, but his teammate Taylor is able to go get it. Taylor still has it. Wrap around, couldn't get the shot off. Puck kicked forward ahead to Cooley. Cooley, who scored a goal, gets it ahead to Rainey, and now comes all the way over to this near side. With the puck, that's Gavin Garrett Johnson. Can't hold on to it. Cheyenne Mountain gets it back. Stick battle as Hovinga had it for Cheyenne Mountain, and now he's the one who comes out of the pack with it. Passes it over to the left side, and Taylor. Taylor, centering pass. Good idea. Stoles was able to stand right there. Cheyenne Mountain still has it in their zone. 2 minutes, 50 seconds to go here in the period. Hovinga can't control. Cadets have it. Let's see if they can get things going. They're kind of tentative coming down the ice.
Yeah, they were, and Cheyenne Mountain really trying to set up a net front presence. Air Academy doing a good job of trying to clear bodies out. There's been a good battle in front of the Air Academy net.
2.5 minutes to go. 2-1 is our score. Cheyenne Mountain leads. We're in the second period. Puck stolen away. Almost an opportunity for Landon Joyle, but he just couldn't quite keep it close enough to him. Now battle for the puck. It's won by Cheyenne Mountain. Long pass comes from right to left, and the Indians try to get things going. Ahead towards Herlihy. Herlihy centers right in front of the net. He was looking for Gasper over there. Didn't get all the way to him, but Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Over to the right side, this is Smith. Smith, the shot. Good save made by Stoles. Comes back around. Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Dumps it in. Back past the circle and behind the goal line. Cadets get it back. We'll see if they try to hurry. On the right side, moving it, that's Joyle. Joyle sends it right to the middle. They've got numbers for a moment. Good poke check. And here comes Cheyenne Mountain in the other direction. Now they're the team with numbers. And puck comes all the way to Stoles, and Stoles is able to drop down in front of it. Stoles is very good at knowing when to play the puck and when not to.
Oh, boy, dangerous play there for Air Academy, because they sent everybody in the zone. They had one of the D pinching in as well, and then Cheyenne Mountain comes right back the other way. Here it is with numbers. They came in, tried to set himself up and push it up ahead. Stoles covers it up, but an odd man rush for Cheyenne Mountain. Cut off by Jason Stoles.
It is the first game of the season. You would think as the periods come towards the end, some of these guys might be a little bit tired out there, and it almost there was a slow motion aspect to that last odd man break for Cheyenne Mountain. 90 seconds to go here in the period. Puck comes out to Smith for Cheyenne Mountain. He dumps it back behind the net. Indians continue to control. Puck's now left back behind. Comes down in the corner. Chiaccia grabs it for Air Academy, comes to the top. Here come the Cadets with it. A little one-on-two break, and nice job by Cheyenne Mountain defensively back there. It was Sauer. Now puck right in front of the net. Still loose. Comes back up towards the blue line. A minute to go here in the period. 2-1 our score. Sauer with it for Cheyenne Mountain. Takes a big bump down there by Taylor for Air Academy. Cheyenne Mountain will try to get one more attack. They have not scored here in this third period, leaving it on the left side. This is Smith with it. Smith sends it down to this near corner. Cheyenne Mountain still with it as they get a quick change. Cadet's trying to come up with the steal. Cheyenne Mountain does a good job to keep it in their zone. Now a stick battle on that far side. Nobody's got control of it quite yet, and the Cadets are just going to send it all the way down the ice. It is not going to cross that red line, and Cheyenne Mountain, well, with 18 seconds to go in the period, try to push into their offensive zone one more time. Air Academy needs one more stop from the left side. This is Hovinga, now right to the middle. What a save made by the goaltender Stoles on a shot by Taylor. You have got to be kidding me.
Well, he's made a ton of saves, but this by far his best one. Look at the glove save. Full extension is going down to seal off the bottom, reaches out with the glove. Here's another look at it coming right at you off the stick of Trevor Taylor. Great save by Stoles.
That is one of the best saves you are going to see in high school hockey. 3 seconds to go, 1 second to go, and we are through two periods. Cheyenne Mountain leads 2-1, but Dave, the Cadets score the only goal of the second period.
And the Cadets outshot 17-5 in that period, but they got the only stat that counts. They got the only goal up on the board, and they head into the intermission down one.
We are through two periods. Cheyenne Mountain leads Air Academy 2-1, and we will have our second intermission report. That's next here on 20 TV.
One part excellent, one part inspiration, one part preparation for outstanding education. Academy School District 20, where dreams take flight.
We are back at the Cadet Ice Arena. It is a 2-1 game. Cheyenne Mountain leads. However, in the second period, it was all Air Academy. As we take a look at the highlights from that second period as the Cadets get on the board. Here you see sometimes being lucky is better than being good, as Katie Cooley was able to put it off the post, carom it off the goalkeeper and back in. And then Jason Stoles was just incredible for the Cadets in the course of the second period, making save after save after save. That is a spectacular save right there. And that makes it a 2-1 game. And we are actually just about set for third period action. Matt Pauly, Dave Toler, our entire 20 TV crew. What's the keys for the Cadets to get a goal or two here in period number two, or period number three, excuse me?
They got to do a better job of getting the puck out of their own end. And when they do get it in their offensive zone, they've had very little sustained offense. They have only 9 shots on goal in this whole game. They've got to find a way to get more pucks to the net and make this Cheyenne Mountain goaltender, Ryan McCann, work a little more.
Initial faceoff was won by Cheyenne Mountain, controlled for a moment by the Cadets. Cheyenne Mountain gets it back. Air Academy gets it back. And 17 seconds in, we've had a very active first few moments. Cadets have it down in the corner. Here's a pass right in front of behind the back shot, and it goes wide right of the goalkeeper, McCann. You would have liked to have seen the Cadets get a little bit more on that shot. Puck in the near corner, finally dug out by Scioli. Here's a centering pass, another opportunity. Cadets can't convert, and here comes the Indians moving from right to left here in this third period. 2-1 game, 16-12 to go. Cheyenne Mountain leads, and they had the puck for a moment in their defensive zone, trying real hard to push it up. Now Air Academy came up with a steal, and Cheyenne Mountain will just bring it back into their defensive zone, and they may try to reset this. That was Wilkie who had it for just a moment. Cadets try to get it. Right now, a lot of changing possessions in this early portion of the third period, and Cheyenne Mountain has it. They'll try to push it up into their zone. 15:40 to go, 2-1 Cheyenne Mountain. Cadets get it back. Dave, neither of these teams can control it seemingly in their zone, and I say that, and here's a possible opportunity on the right side by Herlihy, and again, we see Stoles is there along with some of his teammates.
And Stoles, again, making yet another save. 28 saves in the game for the sophomore. Jason Stoles makes one right there. As you see him diving over to his left side. We're about 90 seconds into this third period. In the first shift of the game, Air Academy got the puck deep. They threw a couple of pucks in front of Ryan McCann. They had one that got in on him. He had to make a save. And you'd like to see more of that for Air Academy. Win a faceoff, get the puck down, and set up your offense a little bit.
Some conversations going on from the Air Academy bench, and one of the officials, the faceoff, is coming just to the left of the goalkeeper, Jason Stoles. Puck is dropped. It is controlled by Cheyenne Mountain. Here's a big shot from the right side. It got deflected. Not very good stick contact on the puck. Comes right in front of the net, gets deflected back out near the top. Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Puck's going to come all the way around the board. It's going to be grabbed down there by Micah McInnes. Kennis skates back behind, falls down, puck comes in front, comes all the way back to the top. Smith, now here's a shot, it goes off of, I don't know if Stoles got a piece of that or who got a piece of it, it deflected in a weird way to that far side. That was a pretty good opportunity for Cheyenne Mountain, but the Cadets live to tell another story. Here's Cheyenne Mountain with it at the top, trying to skate in on the right side, and a shot from the slot that was off the stick of Cameron Sauer. The freshman scored the first goal of the game. Stoles there to make the save, and it's 2-1.
Well, and then the replay up on your screen. Nice play there by Cameron Sauer. Had the puck way up at the blue line. Could have taken that shot instead. Good poise. He pulls it down, dances right around two of the Cadets, gets in on a sharp angle and takes the shot on goal.
Faceoff won by Cheyenne Mountain. Now the puck comes all the way out. Breakaway for the Cadets. Here's a shot. The goal goes! The goal goes! It just trickled through. The Cadets have tied it up as Anthony Scioli scores his first goal of the year, and it is a 2-2 game.
Well, here it is, the breakaway by Scioli. Goes through the five hole of the goaltender. McCann got a good piece of that. The puck just slides over the goal line. Scioli has played a great game, plays back on defense, has had some nice clears in this game, gets an opportunity in the offensive end, gets the breakaway, and buries it to tie this game 2-2. 14:45 left in the third.
The best teams take advantage of opportunities. The opportunity was the puck coming way out. Scioli was right there, and it is a 2-2 game. Whoever's running the scoreboard probably should be made aware of that. 14 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Cheyenne Mountain with it in their offensive zone. There's the shot. Good save made by Stoles. Rebound and putback doesn't go. Cheyenne Mountain still has it. Seems like they have a head of steam. Puck's loose right in front of the net. There's a shot off the stick of Brian Suslow. And again, Stoles is there to make the save. Little battle down there in the corner. Cheyenne Mountain almost feels like they're on a power play right now. Another shot, another save made by Stoles. Rebound comes down in the corner. Cadets need to get this puck and get into their offensive zone just to slow the momentum of Cheyenne Mountain. Teague's got it for the Indians. Now they work it in. Here's a shot from the right side, and Stoles is able to hold on, and that's exactly what the Cadets needed, a stoppage.
Boy, that first shift after a goal is scored is always so huge for both teams. You know, the team that got scored on is going to come out. They want to get it back, but, boy, how about Stoles again? When you need your goaltender to step up and make some big-time saves, he's been there. He made three of them on that last shift.
13 minutes and 45 seconds left. 2-2 game. Cheyenne Mountain has it in their zone, down in the corner. Good defense by the Cadets to knock the puck off. Now it comes out to the right side, a shot and a goal. Cheyenne Mountain answers, as Austin Gasper comes through. It's 3-2 Indians.
Well, when you have that much in zone time like Cheyenne Mountain did, you're bound to get something to go in. Nice pass from the back wall, hits Gasper right up at the bottom of the circle. He goes underneath the pads of Jason Stoles. And for Air Academy, again, you're just giving Cheyenne Mountain too much in zone time. I mean, they could not get the puck out of their own net, and just shot after shot after shot came in on Jason Stoles. That was Austin Gasper with the difference in this one. 13:32 left in the third. The Indians lead 3-2.
Gasper's first goal of the year and the first goal scored since the first period for Cheyenne Mountain. All their goals have gone into this net. 3-2 the score with 13 minutes and 19 seconds left. Cheyenne Mountain leads. The Cadets continuing to have a hard time getting it out of the zone, trying to push it forward. They do get it across center ice, but Cheyenne Mountain's right there defensively as Ryan Smith controls. Smith skates around one Cadet. Now he pushes it forward ahead to Halverson. Halverson centering it over there for McInnes. It goes across McInnes, gets to Pfeffer. Pfeffer couldn't control. Back to the top. Here's Smith. Smith loses it on the near boards. He'll skate back to their defensive zone. It goes off of his stick, and there's Joyle to try to get it for the Cadets. Puck's loose in front of the net. Cheyenne Mountain, though, is there, and they'll try to get going once again. Here's Pfeffer with it. Pfeffer, shot, blocked. Cadets have it. A little head of steam, moving as quick as they can. It's a one-on-three break for Forrest Joyle, and Joyle can't get around Halverson. Halverson sends it ahead. Comes back over to Wilkie. Wilkie had it for a moment. Passes the far side. Cheyenne Mountain very close to having too many men on the ice, as that could have very easily hit the skate of someone who wasn't supposed to be on the ice. Puck back to the top. Now to the slot, right side. Here's a shot. Good block. Nice job by Air Academy defensively. Here's another shot right side. Another block. That time Forrest Joyle got a piece of it. Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Down there it's Hovinga. Hovinga works it up to the top. Taylor puts a shot, and it comes all the way around back to the left side. Cheyenne Mountain just continues to control in their zone. I think that goal may have lit a fuse as the shot and the goal. I think it was tipped right in front of the net, possibly by Trevor Taylor.
Well, and again, just so much in zone time for this Cheyenne Mountain team. Here it is, a shot from the right point goes in. I think it hit one of the Air Academy players. It looked like it might have hit the stick of one of the players up in the circle. Change direction. Yeah, tip by 14.
That's
goes
true.
In the net. 4-2. Cheyenne Mountain leads. 11:44 left in the third.
Trevor Taylor with the tip in. And Taylor, who I've been impressed with today, sophomore forward, scores a goal. And Cheyenne Mountain, they found a new gear when Air Academy tied it up. The best thing that's happened to Cheyenne Mountain this game was Air Academy scoring their second goal. 11:25 left. And Air Academy's got some major work to do. The first thing they got to do is they got to get it out of their defensive zone. Here's Scioli, who scored that second goal. He pushes it ahead for Garrett Johnson. Garrett Johnson can't control. Cheyenne Mountain has it. Just over 11 minutes left. And the Cadets really need to answer with a goal ASAP. Puck sent down back behind the net. It's going to be picked up by Smith back there. Seems like Ryan Smith is always on the ice for Cheyenne Mountain. Smith with it. Trying to skate with it. He'll bring it back behind the goal, and he'll send it over to the left side, and Herlihy. Goes off Herlihy's stick, and Cadets controlled on their defensive side of the ice. Now taken away. This is Herlihy on the left side. Herlihy trying to split a double two players there and not able to do much with it. And puck's loose, and there's a big hit over there. Fans are starting to make a little bit more noise. Cadets have it, trying to get out of their defensive zone. I've said those words a lot tonight. Puck comes up to the net here, to the top. Shot comes back behind the net. Cheyenne Mountain still has it. Here's a shot. It goes off of Stoles right in front of him, and he makes the save.
Well, and you know, when Cheyenne Mountain has the puck this much, Air Academy, they spend so much energy just defending. When you're trying to defend, you're using a lot of energy, and it's just tough to get out of the zone. And Cheyenne Mountain has done a great job. Their defenseman, as you mentioned, Ryan Smith, he gets a lot of ice time, but the defenseman for Cheyenne Mountain, they've done a nice job of keeping pucks in at the blue line.
Tipped away, and it's going to come all the way down the ice. That's where Ryan McCann, the goalkeeper, gets it, and he sends it back down. Cadets have it on their defensive side. They'll get going. Here's Forrest Joyle with it on the left side. Joyle gets a little stick check behind and loses the puck. Left side with it. It's Ortiz. Haven't called his name quite as much here recently. Ortiz can't quite handle it, and Cheyenne Mountain will clear it down the ice. Taken by the Cadets. Pushed ahead to Landon Joyle. And now the puck will scoot down towards the corner. Comes loose. Cadets have it. That's Ortiz. Ortiz gives off. Shot from the left side, and the save is made by McCann. But at least Air Academy kind of got into their offensive flow.
Well, they did, and they got the puck behind the net. They took a shot. They almost got in their own player's way, but they finally get a shot on net. They'll get an offensive zone faceoff, and they needed a line change badly. And now if you can win a faceoff, try to get a little bit of offense going with 9.5 minutes left in the third. Indians up 4-2.
They do win the faceoff. The centering pass came over to Primavera, but Primavera was unable to get that shot off. Air Academy still has a chance to control in their zone. Cheyenne Mountain with the puck. Hovinga, they still have not cleared the zone. It's going to come all the way down the ice, and it will not be played by the goaltender Stoles. Instead, it's an icing, and the Cadets do continue to stay on their offensive side.
Well, there was a while in the second period where, and you had mentioned this, Matt, where it looked like the game just kind of lagged. It was just like they were going back and forth between the neutral zones. But, boy, after Air Academy scored, a new jump to Cheyenne Mountain. They've got some serious legs, and they're getting up and down the ice well.
And it seems like it's taken a little while for Air Academy to match that energy. 9 minutes and 7 seconds left. 4-2, Cheyenne Mountain leads. Last year, the first game between these two teams had a 4-2 final score. However, the Cadets won by that score, not Cheyenne Mountain. 8 minutes and 53 seconds to go. And if you're Cheyenne Mountain, all you want to do at this point is control the puck. Here's Primavera. Thought he may take a shot from the point. Instead, a bad pass, and it's taken away by the Indians. They'll try to push forward. Hovinga gives off to Sauer. Sauer's got it behind the net. Now he kind of passes over to the far side, and Smith, not sure if he meant to do that, right back to Hovinga. Now he pushes it ahead up on the right side, moving forward with it. That's Hovinga. Shot, rebound, poked away. 8 minutes, 18 seconds to go. Puck is still up in the air, grabbing hold of it. Literally, it was Lichtenberger. He puts it down, and he's got it, trying to move it forward. Now it's taken away. This is Herlihy. Herlihy has played a good game, and he tries to go get it. Now it's going to come down in the corner. Cadets try to control. Comes all the way across to the far side circle. Cadets get it back. They'll try to push it forward. Cadets have it across the red line, and it's going to come all the way to the goalkeeper, McCann. He'll sit on it, and with Cheyenne Mountain leading 4-2, a faceoff coming just to the right of the goalkeeper, McCann.
Well, and Cheyenne Mountain's so good with their sticks, too. And Air Academy has skated into those sticks and skated into that pressure so often that Cheyenne Mountain gets in. They break up a lot of plays. They dump it back in deep, and they just keep you on your heels. They're very good with their sticks. And maybe part of that is they got a little bit more game experience than this Air Academy team does.
7 minutes and 43 seconds left. Cheyenne Mountain has a two-goal lead. It's 4-2. We are coming your way from the Cadet Ice Arena inside the Cadet Fieldhouse at the United States Air Force Academy as Air Academy tries to get it ahead. They do so to Habrel. Habrel ahead, left side, puts a shot off. It goes high above the net as McCann was right there with it the whole time. Bit of a collision, circle right side. Now the puck dumped back behind. McCann touches it for a moment, gives off. And Cheyenne Mountain very content to just hold possession when they get it. Here's Herlihy. Herlihy skates, gets it ahead to White. Now back to the top, there's a shot. Not very good contact made. I think that was Herlihy, and it goes up into the net.
Well, and again, there's Cheyenne Mountain holding that blue line. That puck could have came out two different times. They kicked it back in, it came out, they kicked it back in again. Finally took a shot that was tipped up and out of play, and another faceoff here down in the Cadets' end.
7 minutes left, 4-2 is the score. Cheyenne Mountain leads. Face-off, controlled for a moment by Air Academy in their defensive zone, but they're not able to get it back out of the zone. Cheyenne Mountain has it. And you're right, Dave. They just keep keeping it on the inside of that blue line. And finally, the Cadets are able to push it down, but Cheyenne Mountain again gets it, and then it's just the process of moving forward. Here's an opportunity. This is Micah McInnes. McInnes going to the goal shot, and he scores. 5-2, Cheyenne Mountain.
Boy, nice play here by McInnes. Little burst of speed as he goes right through the defenseman, gets in. He's got it on his forehand. Here it is on his forehand. The goaltender Stoles goes down and just can't quite get across to make that save. The goal scored, Micah McInnes, puts the Indians up 5-2, 6:30 left in the third.
Three third period goals. One of the KDAT players just went over and said something to Jason Stoles. You can't put this one on Stoles today. He's just faced too many shots, and eventually the dam opened up.
Well, and he's given his team a chance to win, and that's what you ask of your goaltender so many times. Give us a chance to win, and he's done so.
Here's another shot right side. Goes off of Stoles, down to the corner. 5-2, Cheyenne Mountain leads. 6 minutes and 9 seconds to go. KDAT, if they want to get back in this one, need a goal very soon. Taylor skates down, tries to get his stick on it. Puck's loose. Cheyenne Mountain gets it again. Sometimes it feels like Cheyenne Mountain's got six skaters on the ice. Cadets keep it in the zone, but nobody's down there as they're getting a change. And Cheyenne Mountain gets it again. They'll control, and they'll take their time bringing the puck up the ice. They are in no hurry. 5 minutes and 40 seconds. This game means so much to both teams. They will face each other again later on in the year. Here's a shot. Just goes to the right of the goalkeeper, McCann, and Cheyenne Mountain continues to control. Seems like Cheyenne Mountain is even very comfortable as Joyle comes up with the steal. They're very comfortable controlling in their defensive zone. It doesn't seem like they panic.
Well, they really are, and they run their systems very well. And, again, they've got a little more game experience than a very young Cheyenne Mountain team does. Here's an icing call by the Indians, but you look at them play, and when they get the puck, they're very poised with it. They get behind the net. Their D comes back. Their two wingers go to the boards. It seems like they're very organized. They know what they're doing. And, you know, for Air Academy, I mean, they got to be wondering if we can have another puck to play with, because they haven't had the puck very much in this game. Cheyenne Mountain's had it the whole time. And, you know, if not for some of the saves by Jason Stoles, this score could be much different.
5 minutes and 7 seconds left. One of the Cheyenne Mountain players fell down. He's still down there on the far side of the ice. That's Sauer over there. He seems to be okay. Cadets come up with a steal. Now Sauer gets it back down in the corner. Sauer takes a small hit, not much of one. He loses the puck. Now comes right in front of the net, and unable to put it in was Garrett Johnson. What an opportunity for the Cadets, and they could not convert. Air Academy still has it in their zone. Here's a shot from the top. Rebound given up. Cheyenne Mountain was there again defensively in front of the net. McCann's finally being tested here in this third period. You have to wonder if it's too little, too late. 4.5 minutes left. 5-2, Cheyenne Mountain. Puck is dumped back in. Cadets get a quick change in. Puck comes all the way back to Air Academy on their defensive side of the ice. Now taken away, but offsides, as that was Herlihy who tried to get to it. 4:11 left.
Oh, and here's the last shift for Air Academy. Right in front there, freshman Gavin Garrett Johnson, first collegiate game. And boy, he's had some opportunities tonight. He hasn't gotten the puck clean on his forehand, but we had one in the second period that got tied up in his skates. He had another opportunity right there. So he's getting some chances, just hadn't had a good quality one tonight.
Joyle brings it, was looking for a centering pass. Really nice defensive play by Matt DePepe there to intercept that pass and not give the Cadets a scoring opportunity. Puck is saved in just at the blue line. Now it deflects high up in the air. Man taken down for Cheyenne Mountain. No whistle. Bit of a battle here on these near boards, as you're going to see the physicality of this game go up over the next 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Air Academy with the puck. Sends it across. Now up the middle, taken away. Cheyenne Mountain had it for a moment. Good steal by the Cadets. They've got a 3-on-2 break if they're able to hurry. Here's a bit of a shot. That was Scioli there who tried to put it in, and he got kind of stuck between wanting to pass and wanting to shoot. Cheyenne Mountain has it. 3 minutes and 13 seconds left as they look like they are en route to starting the season 1-0. Cadets look like they may be en route to an 0-1 start, down 5-2 with 3 minutes left. Cadets get a change. Battle for the puck between the blue lines, and finally Air Academy has it. They'll dump it in, and they'll chase it.
Well, and with a 5-2 lead for Cheyenne Mountain after they've got these last three goals, the pace of this game has changed completely. It has slowed down big time. Cheyenne Mountain with that lead. They're keeping a lot of bodies back. They just don't want to give up any goals to Air Academy. And you can see now they're keeping their 2D way back, passing it back to them, and just letting the time run off of this clock.
And they finally find a pass to the middle, but it's stolen away. Nice job by Joyle. Joyle's going to go all the way to the net. Tries to get a shot off. Good save made by McCann. And then defensively, Cheyenne Mountain was there again. Here's a shot from the top. It goes wide right. Puck comes all the way around the boards. Stick battle for it, and it comes back down towards the corner. There's Ryan Smith to get it for Cheyenne Mountain. Smith pushes it ahead to Peloso. First time we've called his name today. Declan Peloso, a junior. Doesn't play that much, but he's back in, or he's in this game. Forrest Joyle has it for the Cadets. Over to Scioli. So Scioli has a goal. Minute 47 left. Cheyenne Mountain controlling the puck. Taking their time. A couple hits down there in the corner. Academy still playing hard. It's going to be real tough for him at this point. Finally comes out to the blue line from the left side. Here's a shot stolen away, or deflects away, really. And here comes Rainey. Rainey tries to get it, and a good job back there by A.J. Wilkie, who made maybe one of the best defensive plays we've seen today.
Yeah, really did. I mean, just stood his ground, played the body, knocked the puck away, and they sent it down the other end.
And the game continues to be very physical, as you would expect. These two schools tend not to like each other. Here's Joyle. Joyle tries to get around a couple Cheyenne Mountain players. Cheyenne Mountain controls for a moment. 60 seconds left. Another collision right around the blue line. That results in the Cadets being able to save the possession in their zone. But Andy T goes and gets it for Cheyenne Mountain. 50 seconds left. Gasper brings it up for the Indians. Gasper on the right side. Puts a shot on goal. Rebound given up. Comes to a Cadet. Just shot around the boards, and it's going to come all the way down the ice. There are 29 seconds left. 5-2 contest. Pushed ahead, stolen away. But Cheyenne Mountain does remain in control of it. 19 seconds left. The Cheyenne Mountain student section making a lot of noise as their team is en route to victory and a 1-0 start. 9 seconds to go here at the Cadet Ice Arena. Puck deep in the defensive zone for Air Academy. Centering pass comes out to the top, and a last-second shot not going to count. 5-2, the final score, as Cheyenne Mountain gets the win. They revenge one of the two losses from last year to Air Academy, and Cheyenne Mountain starts the season off with a 1-0 record. We'll come back with our 20 TV post-game wrap. That's next here on 20 TV.